What's going on, you guys? Welcome to the Single Guy channel. My name's Lloyd. So today we're going to talk about a question that this guy writes. So here's the message. Lloyd, big fan of your channel. I had a question for you. I was seeing a girl for a few months, but lately she was not responding to my messages as much as she was before, and she started flaking on our plans. When I finally talked to her about this, she revealed she sees me more as a friend and doesn't see a future of us as romantic partners. I know you say to move on in situations like these, but I find myself thinking about her throughout the day, when I wake up, and when I go to bed. It's starting to affect my work now. How can I stop obsessing over this girl? Cool. Yeah, man. So I talk about this a lot, and I would say probably this is one of the most common messages that I get. And look, dude, I know what you're going through. It sucks. When you have a girl that you really like and things don't work out, it's natural for your body to, or your mind, to start to think about her a lot. And for some people, they will tend to obsess about people for a lot longer than is reasonable or is healthy, okay? And in fact, in today's situations, a lot of times breakups are probably the most traumatic events that either of us are gonna really experience in our lives. You know, beyond us, if you've served in a war or something like that, I'm sure that would be, that would top, but most of us have not done that. So in this video, what I'm gonna be talking about is I'm gonna be talking about how to stop obsessing slash being anxious over a girl. So I've talked about this topic in previous videos, but I'm really going to delve into dealing with the pain aspect of it, okay? So step number one, I've talked about this before, delete her from all the apps that you have. If you have her on Instagram, if you have her on, you know, friends on Facebook or something like that, unfollow her on Instagram, unfollow her on Facebook. You don't have to unfriend her or block her or any of that stuff. Just make sure she's not popping up in your newsfeed or anything like that. If you guys have mutual friends, that maybe can cause problems if you're blocking somebody, but just try to not be around her when she's around, okay? Things that are gonna remind you of her are gonna make it harder for you to move on. And the sooner you cut ties with those things, the sooner it's going to be able for you to be able to move on. Okay, so that's thing number one. Thing number two, typically guys, when they start obsessing or they start getting anxious over a girl, it's because there's something missing. Okay, so you had your life in a certain way. It was probably not that great when she came into your life. There was something missing, there was maybe you weren't that happy, whatever it was, a piece of happiness came in and you did everything in your power to try and hold on to that happiness. And when it left you, you were basically left with nothing. So it was a huge, loss to you. You know, whatever this girl meant to you or whatever her personality or qualities were, what she meant to you was a significant amount of happiness. And after she left, now your brain is thinking, I gotta get this thing back. Okay. So what that means is that the situation, your environment, everything around there is not where it should be. Okay. Your environment should already be pretty good. When somebody comes into your life, they make it better, but it should already be good to begin with. And chances are, dude, that might have been part of the reason why she broke up with you in the first place. I know it's a harsh truth, but having a good lifestyle, being a happy person, and having just things that are going on with you that are, you know, engaging, that are gonna make you, for your well-being and stuff, women look for that. You know, people look for that in a partner, and maybe she found out that that was not the case when she was hanging out with you. I don't know, I'm just guessing. But I'm saying if your environment wasn't good right now, that's why you're obsessing over this person. So it's become, so the number one thing that I would recommend that you do is focus on yourself and make sure that you can improve those aspects of your environment. Okay, so what are the parts of the environment that you should improve upon, okay? Your support system. You got friends, family, people that support you and love you, okay, that aren't her. Number two, you have a career or you have a path or something that you're going down. Now, I know if you're a young guy, sometimes it's difficult for you to find. So try new things and be passionate about trying to find that. Okay, and get regular exercise, sunlight, all of those things. I know this is kind of tough, especially with the quarantine situation right now. A lot of people are breaking up. And so, you know, on a day like today, where it's actually sunny, I could get out in the balcony or in the backyard or something like that. Go for a walk, whatever it is, those things will help, okay? So make sure you're improving your life in all of those different ways. And remember, you guys, I always say that you should not put your significant other or you should not put a girl as the number one priority in your life. The first priority is yourself. The second priority is your career. The third priority is your family. And after that, maybe a girl that you're seeing or a girl that you're interested in can come in fourth, okay? If you have those priorities in right, a lot of times when she leaves, you're still gonna be okay. All right, the next thing that I would do as well too, dude, is that you might have thought that this person was perfect. You might have thought that this person was like the perfect, you know, perfect person for you or whatever. She's not. Newsflash, she's not. Especially if she doesn't want to be with you or doesn't see you as a romantic option. Yeah, she's not perfect for you, okay? Me, the first criteria when I'm gonna meet someone that I like, okay? First criteria is not how hot they are. First criteria is not the personality or any of those types of things. First criteria is that she's into me. Okay? And if this person is not into me, well, that's not a good match for me. Okay? But beyond that, I want you to write down every single negative quality that you could think about her. You know, that time where she chewed too loudly, that time where she was being negative when, you know, you were trying to have a good time, or maybe she was being a downer. I don't know. Maybe you guys conflicted on certain issues. Maybe she wasn't as motivated as you. Maybe she, I don't know, whatever it was for this particular person, I'm sure there is stuff. Maybe you're not thinking about it so hard now because you're thinking about what you lost, but write down all of those qualities when you have a conscious, free, clear mind. Write them all down and actually put them on your phone. Put them on your phone, get a notepad, put them on your phone, and every time you start to think about her, I want you to bring up that notepad and look at all of those negative qualities, okay? This is a good technique for not just men, but for women too. If you know, a guy dumps you or leaves you for some, you know, other bimbo, put all of those negative qualities on your phone, and every time you're thinking about that person, look at it, okay? That's a pretty good, easy reminder to tell yourself, hey, listen, this person wasn't perfect, and I should probably stop thinking about them as much as I are. Okay, so those are all the tips that I have. And as well too, once you start to learn about your body, about your mind, the things that you, the traps that you fall into, how you got to this place in the first place, you're gonna start to understand kind of your dating process a lot better. Meaning that the way you meet people, the way you go into relationships, maybe you're falling too quickly too soon. Why is that happening? Maybe there's something wrong with your environment. Like I said, your support system's not there. Maybe it's you're putting too much expectations on the relationship and no one's ever gonna fulfill them. You need to start asking yourself these tough questions. These are the types of questions that I ask my clients in my coaching programs, especially if we're doing a one-on-one client. I really delve deep into this and we come up with an answer. So I would recommend that you do that same thing too. If you need a coach, I'm your guy to help out. So thanks for watching, you guys. If you made it to the end, consider subscribing. Come out with videos like this every single week. If you're interested in my weekly one-on-one coaching program, or one-on-one, or the mastermind, or whatever, form down below, fill out the form, and we'll get back to you. Thanks a lot, you guys. Good luck.